Hi, I'm Norman Wildberger. Today we're going to look at chromogeometry using the Geometer Sketchpad to illustrate that the nine-point circle actually has three different manifestations that all pleasantly interact with each other. So our starting point is a triangle, A1, A2, A3, in the usual Cartesian plane, so we have fixed coordinate axes. We'll start with the midpoints of the triangle, and joining those to the opposite vertices, the three medians. And those three medians intersect at the centroid G of the triangle. The altitudes of the triangle, in the usual sense, or the blue sense, meet at the orthocenter. The three perpendicular bisectors meet at the circumcenter. And the circumcenter is the center of the unique circle that passes through the three points of the triangle. Furthermore, the centroid, the circumcenter, and the orthocenter are collinear, and passing through them is the blue Euler line. And on this blue Euler line, there's an extra interesting point, which is halfway between the circumcenter and the orthocenter. That's called the nine-point center. It's right here. And it is the center of also a circle that passes through the three midpoints of the triangle. Now this circle has many other interesting properties. In particular, there are other points which lie on it. That's why it's called the nine-point circle. So what other points lie on it? Well, the feet of the altitudes lie on it, as well as the midpoints of the lines joining the orthocenter to the vertices. So we have 9 points altogether on that 9-point circle, but we'll soon see that there's a few other points as well. All right, now let's have another look at the same configuration with red geometry. So here are the red altitudes, and that means that those are lines from a vertex which is perpendicular to the opposite side, in the red sense. We see that the red altitudes meet at a point. This point is the red orthocenter. And moreover, we see that it actually lies on the blue circle. The three perpendicular bisectors, in the red sense, meet at the red circumcenter. This point is also the center of a circle, now a red circle, which passes through the three points of the triangle. This red circle is actually a rectangular hyperbola with asymptotes of slope 1 and minus 1. There's its center. We also know that the red circumcenter actually lies on the blue 9-point circle. In fact, that's going to be true even if we vary the situation, as Geometer Sketchpad allows us to do. Now the red circumcenter, the centroid of the triangle, and the red orthocenter also lie on a line. That's the red Euler line. And halfway between the circumcenter and the orthocenter is the nine-point center, which is also the center of the unique red circle, which passes through the three midpoints of the triangle. Now, this red nine-point circle also has other points which lie on it, exactly in parallel with the blue usual nine-point circle, even though it's actually a rectangular hyperbola. In particular, the feet of the altitudes. Oh, it must be down in this direction here. Sometimes these things are off the page. Also, the orthogonal midpoints is halfway between the red orthocenter and the various vertices of the triangle. So there's one here, and one here, and we can see all of them. So those are 9 points lying on the red 9-point circle. And in fact, we see there's at least one additional point, because the blue circumcenter also lies on that red 9-point circle. And now we can look at the same thing with the green geometry. There are the three green altitudes, meeting at their green orthocenter. And the three green perpendicular bisectors meet at the green circumcenter, right here. The line joining the green circumcenter and the green orthocenter, that's the green Euler line, also going through the centroid. And halfway between those two points on that line is the, where is it? Green nine-point center. All right, the green circumcircle through the three points is there, and the green nine-point circle is there. And again, we see the same kind of patterns that we did for the red one. The nine-point circle in the green sense also passes through some additional points. In particular, it passes through the feet of the altitudes, green altitudes, one there, one down here, and I'm not sure there. Where's the other one? I can't really see it offhand. It's somewhere. And also the orthogonal midpoints. These are the points. There is one, and there is one. These are halfway between the green orthocenter and the three vertices of the triangle. And that's a pretty complete picture. To put it all together, we look at the omega triangle of the original triangle. This is the triangle which joins the three orthocenters, and that embraces most of the other stuff because the circumcenters are the midpoints of that triangle, and halfway between those midpoints are the three nine-point centers. And as we vary our original starting point, we see that the nine-point circles, the orthocenters, the Euler lines, the omega triangle, they all vary in a pleasant fashion. All right, so this shows us that chromogeometry is really revealing a brand new symmetry and structure into traditional planar Euclidean geometry. But how do we go about proving the facts that I've stated today and other ones? Well, next time we're going to have a look at proofs in chromogeometry. I hope you'll join me for that. I'm Norman Wildberger. Thanks for listening.